Trench warfare is a war tactic in which opposing armed forces attack, counterattack, and defend from relatively permanent systems of trenches dug into the ground. They consist of different sectors where each line demonstrated a role performed by soldiers. Trench warfare has greatly contributed to the devastating outcomes of the First World War, some of which will be viewed in this video.
The trenches were dug out in a zigzag pattern to ensure that if an enemy entered the trench, he could not fire straight down the line. Barbed wires had little impact on tanks, but men caught on them would be easy to shoot and kill by the opposite side. Sandbags were used to reduce damage to the trench, but to also protect the men from enemy fire and to ensure that the walls of the trench did not suddenly collapse. The ammunition shelf is where soldiers kept their ammunition and guns. Dugouts provided protection from shelling. The front line was considered to be the start point to any over-the-top attack on the enemy, and was the riskiest layer for soldiers following no man's land. The support line aided the front line trench in the case of an enemy attack and was also responsible for providing supplies of food and ammunition to the soldiers on the front line. The reserve line was located behind the support line, where soldiers took a break from being on the front line. Communication trenches allowed access for soldiers to move supplies from trench to trench without being exposed to their rivals. No man's land was a term used by soldiers to identify the ground between the two opposing trenches. When attacks occur in the area, no man's land would be full of broken and abandoned military equipment, as well as tremendous amounts of bodies scattered around. However, advances across the area were significantly difficult, and as a result, soldiers were only occasionally involved in a full-scale attack across the area.
Living conditions in the trenches proved to be catastrophic due to a broad range of factors. Soldiers lived in continuous fear due to having to witness the loss of their fellow mates, sudden attacks, starvation, lack of hygiene, and the ongoing chain of diseases. To start off, soldiers of World War I were the first to develop shell shock, which is a psychological disease rather than a physical one, and its severeness often aggravated over time, making it impossible for soldiers to fight on the front line. In addition, the extreme lack of hygiene on trenches had also led to the widespread of trench rats, which had carried with them more diseases due to the lack of system of waste disposal. Soldiers often urinated in a tin and threw it out of the trench as latrines were positioned as far away as possible from fighting and living space, thus leading to an increase in the unsanitary atmosphere around them. Also, soldiers were covered in mud, dirt, and blood, however the lack of water made bathing a luxurious aspect. Weather conditions were an additional element that contributed to the wide-ranging diseases. During the winter, the trenches were damp and cold as a result of the harsh rain and snow, which led to a disease known as trench foot caused by fungal infections. In the summertime, soldiers witnessed a disease known as dysentery caused by unsanitary water, which left soldiers with no option other than drinking water provided from shell holes or melted snow. This severely damaged the intestines, leading to several symptoms such as diarrhea, fever, and vomiting. Lack of clean water and dehydration was also a cause of mortality. Other factors such as body lice inhabited the seams of soldiers' clothing, hence leading to another disease known as trench fever. Despite trench fever not being ultimately serious, its recovery ranged from 5 days to 12 weeks, depending on its severity.
Throughout the war, the Germans began using chlorine and mustard gas as chemical weapons. Chlorine gas produced a greenish-yellow cloud that smells of bleach and immediately irritates the eyes, nose, lungs, and throat of those exposed to it, whereas one drop of mustard gas attacked the whole body. A drop of the chemical weapon could cause skin burns on soldiers within 10 cubic meters, and despite soldiers being equipped with gas masks, they proved to be useless because mustard gas could penetrate the filters of the mask, also proving to be deadly to its own troops if carried in the wrong direction by the wind.
The government usually exaggerated the food that would be offered to the soldiers as a strategy to encourage or attract more men to enlist in the army. However, reality proved that the food being provided to soldiers was barely adequate. As the war progressed, the ration of food provided was decreasing, and this was apparent for the British Army. At the beginning of the war, British soldiers were given 10 ounces of meat and 8 ounces of vegetables a day. However, in 1916, these rations were reduced to 6 ounces of meat a day due to the increase in the size of the army and the German blockade becoming more effective. According to the dietitians, soldiers needed to consume much more than the recommended 3,574 calories a day, yet the bulk of the soldiers' diet consisted of bully beef, bread, and biscuits. Biscuits were a key component of soldiers' rations. However, they were extremely hard to the extent that they could break teeth if not soaked in water or tea.
What else did soldiers do other than fight? Boredom was common. However, soldiers would force themselves not to sleep even during their free time, as they would severely be punished by their commanding officers. So they repaired barbed wires, refilled sandbags, and raided trenches to consume their time. Other chores including cleaning weapons, mining, and daily inspections, and sometimes soldiers played cards or wrote letters.
The extent of death witnessed was tremendous in trenches, or as they were usually referred to, hell on earth. Military death totaled 9.7 million, 21.2 million as wounded, and 7.5 million as prisoners, hence signifying the vast loss of lives caused by the war. The weapons used were also very deadly. The bolt-action rifle could be fired in a minute, and a person 1,400 meters away could be killed, while the machine gun had the firepower of 100 guns and could deliver devastating blows to the enemy.